or twice. Dug my way out, blood and fire. Bad decisions, that's alright. Welcome to my silly life. Mistreated, misplaced, misunderstood, misknown.
Hello, my friends. Today I'm back with. Oh shit! What was that? I'm sorry. Sometimes when I pull on my balls, I have some different, really weird accent. So sorry about that. But as you can see, today I have the ugliest team possible to have in FIFA. It's an absolute disgrace to the human race. So let's go on to our first player here, and it is our goalkeeper. You can already tell that TSK. Come on, man. But look at this picture, he is so fat, he looks like baked potato. All he needs is a little bit of cheese and sour cream, and you can serve him next to your main plate and Applebee's. Absolutely amazing how you can be so fat and be a footballer, especially goalkeeper. How can they make saves like this? Unbelievable. Let's go on to the next player here. I'm getting cancer from this. So obviously here I have Mamadou Sakho. I mean, come on, you cannot leave him out. He's obviously the devil. Obviously, there's no chance he is not the devil. Just look at his eyes. It is unbelievable. He is staring into your soul, awaiting your arrival in hell. Like, this. If you did not know, he was left out of the squad against Stoke City because his wife had a devil spawn baby. I don't understand. He's probably going to be gone for a while to teach the baby the ways of being a devil just like him. I think that if you look at him for too long, that eventually you will like disintegrate because of his devil abilities. Look at him, 2 stars. Have you seen him dribbling? Let me show you a picture of him, a video of him dribbling. Look at this. Absolutely unbelievable. I cannot believe Liverpool actually bought him. There were so many other options, but they had to go with this devil. I don't understand, but I mean, sometimes he is good, so I'm not going to complain. Let us just go on to next player here. His name is Ferreira or something. He's not exactly ugly, but his hair, that is the only reason why I chose him in this team, was because the thing on his head, I'm not sure what it is. But yeah, not much to it. He's not that bad looking, but he's still pretty ugly. Let's go on to next player. So our next player here is probably one of the ugliest ones here. Look at him, Eiling. This picture looks like he was beaten up, raped in public, beaten up again by his own teammates, and then went to go take the team picture. Look at him, what is that shit under his eyes? It looks like he hasn't slept since the last time Liverpool won the league. Absolutely disgusting. Let's go on to next player. I think this picture is giving me Down syndrome. So here next we have my cousin, I mean, not my cousin, Falata, and his brother is in this team too, his brother. And he is probably more attractive and one of the more attractive people in the team. But I don't understand. When you see his brother, you will understand. I don't get how his parents can give birth to such dark skin messes like this. He is bronze, dude. The only thing good about him is that he has good pace. What is that, like 85 or something? So yeah, that is main reason why he's in this team. Now let's go on to our next player. No, not really. Let's go to Angel Di Maria. Look at him. Doesn't he look just like Dobby? It is unbelievable their resemblance. It is unbelievable. But yeah, he failed at Manchester United and now he is the snake slithering to the next team that offers him the most money. He failed at Manchester United. I do not understand why. And he did good at Real Madrid. I don't understand why he didn't do good at Manchester United. He did good at the beginning, but now he just went into trash. I'm not going to talk more about him because I used to like him a lot. So let's go on to next player. So now we have Fatala's brother Albrahim, and as you can see, he is absolutely trash in this game. I don't understand why he's a professional footballer. He is much better at his terrorist job. His construction job. Yeah, his construction job, because he can build stuff with his small height very good. He won't fall off with his. If he was tall and unbalanced. But yeah, I keep on telling him, please give up football, you're very very bad. He ends up crying and then I have to console him, and then very bad. So And he's just going to rot in the team he plays for in the reserves. So let's go on to the next player, because I don't want to talk bad about him. He's going to tell our leader, I mean his mother. So now we have the next player here. I don't know how to pronounce his name. Poi Greiner or something. He is albino. He is trash center back. And there's not much to say about him. He kind of looks like a thumb, but okay. I just want you to stare at him. Just stare at him for a good 10 seconds. Do you have cancer now? Well, you should. Let's go on to the next player. Okay, let's go to... No. Let's go to Palacio and look. He looks regular player, right? Regular, normal player, but no. Look at this. He has a red tail. It looks like he got red from that one cooking show or movie or whatever, I don't know. And he just put them together and boom, there is red tail. I don't understand why people don't just pull his red tail down during the game. I mean, that must be the reason why he did not score a single goal at the World Cup. He's so trash, he only scored like 5 goals for Inter or whatever. Very bad player at the same time. So next player here we have Carlos Tevez, and I do not want to make fun of him too much because when he was smaller he had the boiling pot of water fall on his head, and that is why he has probably that little scar on his neck. Not little, it is huge, but yeah, that is why he is ugly. He could do a little more about himself to make him prettier, like use moisturizer once in a while, but that is pretty much it about him. And the last player we have today is Frank Ribery. He is a little bit like Carlos Tevez because he had problem when he was 2 years old. He got in a car accident and he had hundreds of stitches in his face. So that is 50% not his fault, but the other 50% is 100% his fault. Look at his teeth. It is the ugliest piece of teeth I've ever seen. He should be like Ronaldo and actually get braces and fix it, but no. The only thing good about him is that he is actually a good player. Just like Tevez, they're both ugly and good. So yeah, by far he is the ugliest player in the world, but still he is amazing. So that is it for the ugliest team possible to get in FIFA. I wanted to put players like Mario Balotelli, but there just wasn't enough room, so I could only do this. So thank you for watching and see you next time.